Hardly a showdown in Portland today. Wow, the Blazers shot down the Jazz on home court.
And now the Jazz trail the Blazers 2-1 in the best of 7 series, and David is here with a look.
I'm sorry.
Okay. It's a painful look.
Yeah. The truth of the matter is the Jazz have looked better. Jerry Sloan tried every lineup. He tried every set play, and it just kept getting worse and worse. Jerry, a little worked up. If you only watched 6 minutes, I hope you saw the first 6 minutes. Karl Malone, 25 points, 14 rebounds. Jazz up 14-9, and that's when it all goes wrong. Brian Grant with the bucket on the offensive rebound. Blazers up 22-16 after one quarter. Brian Russell tried 8 shots and missed them all. A 19-zip run for the Blazers. 19 unanswered points. Walt Williams for 3 at the end of this break. 47-30, Portland by 17 at the half. Jazz rallied a little bit in the second half. Rasheed Wallace throwing down the dunk and the foul. Blazers cruise 97-87. They lead the series 2-1, game 4 tomorrow night. Now, the Jazz loss was tough on everyone watching on TV, but you can imagine going all the way to Oregon and seeing this nightmare. Dave Fox is there, and Dave, there were a few Jazz fans in the Rose Garden today.
Yes, there were, and some very familiar ones. You know, of course, the most familiar faces of the Delta Center night in and night out, David, are the players, but aside from that, the Jazz dancers, those that entertain the crowd during the timeouts. Well, the entire dance group paid their own way to come all the way up here and watch this team play. Yeah, they weren't thrilled with what they saw, especially considering that they did make such a long trek, and they did pay their own way.
But we got ourselves here to Portland. If we could get to Portland, they'd get us in the game. That was the deal.
We thought it would be such a neat opportunity to come up here and be able to support the team. We normally don't get to travel, and all of us wanted to come up here.
Okay, now the Jazz have to battle the Blazers on the court. That's one war. But how would you guys measure up against the Blazer girls?
We are number one all around. The Jazz team, the Jazz dancers, the Jazz bear, all of us.
Yeah, tough to sit up here and not, I mean, during those timeouts, you see the Blazer girls going and you're just...
Yeah, we miss it, but we're having fun just up here cheering.
The Jazz dancers are having a great time on their visit to Portland, but they're the first ones to admit there's no place like home.
There's only one Blazer fan that's, like, even being nice to us, and he thinks the Jazz are going to go on a run, so.
Rest of it, how could they possibly be mean to you guys?
They want the Blazers to win as much as we want the Jazz to win. So when we're over there cheering and screaming, they're going, boo.
Jazz dancers actually had seats scattered throughout the arena, so there was a little bit of Jazz representation, you know, here and there, and they're hoping that tomorrow night will be a better outcome for them. Join us a little bit later on for the Sports Den. Coach Majerus will be here. Jeff Hornacek will be here. We'll look back and look ahead. Dave Fox reporting live from Portland. Brian?
Dave, the Portland dancers are good, but the Jazz dancers, come on, they're better.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, we asked them that, and they said, yeah, we are, but I will tell you, honestly, the Jazz dancers are among the best at any arena I've seen.
Kind of had to been tough to sit there and not be out there dancing, though.
Yeah, well, you know, we asked them about that as well, and the players have their own game going on. Yeah, they kind of judge the other girls, but every time out, they had their eyes glued on the performance, but then they would get up and start dancing a little bit themselves as well, just in the stands. The fans love that in Portland.
Putting them in different spots is a good strategy.
Yeah, it was.
All right, thanks, Dave.
Better luck next time for the team. There's